गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स. एक्चुअली जस्ट वी आर इन स्टिल इन फर्स्ट यूनिट. एक्चुअली जस्ट आई वांट टू रिकैप्चुलाइजेशन व्हाट वी लर्न अप टू नाउ बिकॉज दिस टॉपिक टुडे एक्चुअली वी विल डिस्कस क्लियरली इंटेंसिटी ड्यूरेशन फ्रीक्वेंसी. इट इज नथिंग बट ए आइडिया. इट इज नथिंग बट ए आइडिया कॉज एंड probable maximum precipitation PMP. These are important and the interlinking to the previous subtopic. So that's why I want to recapitulation to all of you what we learned in first unit. Actually first we learned engineering hydrology and its applications and hydrological cycle, hydrological data and sources of data and precipitations and types and forms, measurement, rain gauge network, presentation of rainfall data, average rainfall, continuity and consistency of rainfall data, frequency of rainfall. These are all we discussed in our in previous classes. Now we are discussed today first intensity duration frequency idea. Guys, here if the rainfall data from a recording rain gauge is available for a longer period such as 40 or 50 years, the frequency of occurrence of given maximum intensity can also be determined. Here just what he says, for example, if the rainfall data from a recording rain gauge is available for a longer period such as 40 to 50 years. Guys, if we establish a rain gauge, for example, in MRO office or some other locations, we can identify easily rain gauge stations which are established in 40 years ago or 50 years ago, example. That type of rain gauge stations only, it will give the just a large information and we can research that. But here the frequency of occurrence of a given maximum intensity, frequency of occurrence of a given maximum intensity can also be determined. Then we obtain the intensity frequency duration relationship. Here intensity, frequency and duration. Here just the relationship means, duration means, here intensity means like 10 mm or 20 mm or 30 mm. Actually rainfall we are measuring in millimeters or centimeters, but probably all are using mm. Here intensity means, for example, if we take one day or two, for example, if we take one day, if rainfall has happened 30 mm, that is the 30 mm or 20 mm, 40 mm, 50 mm, that is the intensity. Frequency means, for example, frequency means, for example, if we consider a month, if we consider a month, how many days, for example, 20 days are rainy in a out of 30 days, or 15 days in a 15 days in a month, I mean out of 30 days, or 10 days or 5 days. Here frequency means number of days. The intensity means 20 mm, 30 mm, in mm's we have to collect. Frequency means days. Duration means 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, 4 hour. That is called the duration. So here we have to establish a relationship between the intensity, frequency, duration. Intensity means 30 mm or 40 mm. Frequency means like 20 days, 25 days, 10 days, 5 days. That is one. And duration is the 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours. We have to establish between the intensity, frequency, duration relationship here. And the procedure to obtain such a relationship is now described. Here, every storm in a year is analyzed. Every storm in a year is analyzed to find the maximum intensities for various durations as described in the previous section. Every storm in a year is analyzed. Every storm in a year is analyzed to find the maximum intensities for various durations as described in the previous section. Thus, each storm gives one value of maximum intensity for a given duration. Here what he says, every storm gives one value of maximum intensity for a given duration. The largest of all such values is taken to be the maximum intensity in that year for that duration. Likewise, the annual maximum intensity is obtained for all the durations. Similar analysis yields the annual maximum intensities for various durations in different years. It will then be observed that the annual maximum intensity for any given duration is not the same every year, but it varies from year to year. In other words, it behaves as a random variable. So if 50 years of record is available, then there will be 50 values of the maximum intensity of any duration which constitute a sample of the random variable. These 50 values of any duration can be subjected to the frequency analysis is explained in previously. And the maximum intensity of rainfall for various return periods can be obtained. Similar frequency analysis is carried out for other durations also. Then, from the results of this analysis, graphs of maximum rainfall intensity against the return period for various durations such as those is developed. The same results can be depicted in a different but more convenient from this figure. From the curves of the maximum intensity of rainfall for any duration and for any return period can be read out here. Thus, here I will show you a video, a figure. In this figure, here intensity frequency curve, here return periods and the maximum intensity, maximum rainfall intensity, 6 hours, 2 hours, 1 hour, 30 minutes, 15 minutes. The intensity and the frequency. So maximum rainfall intensity is just 6 hours or 1 hour, 2 hours, 6 hours or 30 minutes or 15 minutes. This indicates the intensity and frequency curve. Here intensity frequency duration curve is here the same. Here guys, what happened? Intensity frequency duration 6 hours, 2 hours, 1 hour, and 30 minutes, 15 minutes. That's same happen here. For example, some amount of the water, the intensity frequency duration 2 years, 5 years, 25 years, 50 years, and 100 years. The duration is, in this duration, we can get the maximum intensities. Alternatively, for any constant return period, an equation from the given equation 5.6 can be filled between the maximum intensity and duration. That is, I is equal to C1 by T plus A1 whole to the power of B1. I is equal to C2 by T plus A2 whole to the power of B2, where C1 and small a1 and b1 are applicable for one return period. Trn and c2, a2 and b2 are applicable for another return period. Tr2 etc. Generally, it will be observed that the constants a and b are approximately same for all the return periods, and only c is different for different return periods. In such a case, one general equation may be developed for all the return periods as given by I is equal to kt r to the power of d by t plus a to the power of b, where tr is the return period in years and k and small d are the regression constants for a given location. If a and b are not same for all the return periods, then an individual equation for each written period may be used. When the intensity frequency duration analysis is carried out for a number of locations in a region, the relationships may be given in the form of equation 5.9 with a different set of regression constants for each location, or alternatively they may be presented in the form of maps with each map depicting maximum rainfall depths for different combinations of one return period and one duration, which can be more conveniently used especially when one is dealing with large areas. Such maps are called the isofluvial maps. A map showing the maximum rainfall depths for a duration of 1 hour, which can be expected with a frequency of once in 50 years over the South India, is here given figure. Guys, here isofluvial map of 50 years 1 hour rainfall over South India. Here this map what indicates? Isofluvial map of 50 years 1 hour rainfall over South India. Guys, from this map we can observe, from map this can observe, this is the 50 years in 1 hour rainfall over South India means. For example, here Sholapur and Ballari is there. It indicates 1 hour rainfall is 70 mm in 50 years in 1 hour. And also, so in South India, the isofluvial map we can understood. For example, if we take the 70, that is in South India, the taken areas are Solapur, Ballari, and 80 is and 80 also Solapur and Ballari, and 90 also it will take Hyderabad and Bangalore, this all area in the last 50 years, and 100, if we consider the 100, that is also Hyderabad and Hyderabad, Tirchinapalli and Otakkamand, Mangaluru and Panjim, these areas. And if you take 120, that is also again Tirchinapalli, Ottachamudu and Pondicherry, Madras, Nellur, Masalasipuram and Kakinada and Visakhapatnam. And again 140, it's also to take in Uttaranchal, 120. So these are the isofluvial map of 50 years, 1 hour rainfall over the South India. Guys, here the another curve is probable maximum precipitation. We have to call as a PMP, probable maximum precipitation. The greatest depth of rainfall
that can occur in a given duration at a given location is known as the possible maximum or the probable maximum precipitation, abbreviated as PMP. It is the upper limit of the physically possible precipitation depth. It has been defined as the depth of precipitation which for a given area and duration can be reached but not exceeded under known meteorological conditions. If PMP for a given catchment is estimated, then it can be used to provide an estimate of the probable maximum flood, abbreviated as PMF, after appropriate adjustments for infiltration losses. The PMF has virtually no risk of being exceeded. There are two approaches for estimating. The PMP. The first approach uses the maximization and transposition of real or model storms, which the second approach utilizes the statistical analysis of the extreme rainfall. In the storm maximization and transposition technique, the upper limits of the amount of moisture available in the air above the basin, the rate at which the wind may carry moist air into the basin, and the fraction of the inflowing water vapor that can precipitate are estimated from the available meteorological data. This indeed requires a large amount of data than assuming that the maximum air moisture and the maximum air inflow occur simultaneously. The maximum precipitation that may occur is derived in the absence of suitable data over the area under consideration. The storms from very large distances are transposed with modification for factors such as elevation, latitude, and distance from moisture source. Storms are not transposed in mountainous regions because it is not possible to adjust precipitation accurately for orographic influences. In the statistical approach, the annual series of the observed maximum rainfall depth for given duration are analyzed to yield the mean and standard deviation. PMP is expressed as the mean of the series plus k times the standard deviation. That is, PMP is equal to p naught plus k to sigma. The value of k is empirically determined. It varies with rainfall duration and inversely with the mean of the series. It ranges is between 5 and 30. The PMP value estimated for a location is then to equation so that it can be made applicable over a given area. Guys, here I want to show a small slide. Guys, here I want to show a I want to show a PPT. It's regarding the IDF curves and the PMF curves. Basic characteristics.
guys, here there's idea called intensity, duration, frequency, cost. In general, the higher the intensity of the rainfall, the shorter the duration of it will be. Intensity, duration, frequency, idea of relationship is important for engineers in designing hydraulic structures. It is shown by a family of curves. Each curve is drawn for a certain frequency and indicates the change of intensity with respect to the time interval called the reference time interval, duration of the storm. Here, just the intensity, duration, frequency, cost for the sample duration as frequency and intensity. Here, intensity, mm per hour. Here, reference time, minutes to hour. Here, frequency, 10 years, 25 years, 50 years. Here, 10 years, I50. Intensity, mm, 50 mm in 10 years. And above 50 mm, 25 years. And above 50 is 50 years. Here, for the same frequency as duration intensity, 20 minutes, 35 minutes, 50 minutes reference in the time. Here, frequency 10 years, 25 years, and 50 years. I50, I35, I20. Statistical analysis of maximum storms observed in the study area are used in general. No, actually, this is not useful to you. Just for our identification, I showed the idea. Okay, guys, thank you for your patience. In next class, I will complete the chapter 1. Thank you.